like a swarm of locusts. The Mongol horde emerged from the east, driven by a madman named Genghis Khan. When we first heard the rumors of their approach, we thought the Mongols were but mere bands of raiders, not unusual on the steppes. But when spies from the east told us that the Mongols had utterly destroyed the Persian Empire, putting its civilians to the sword and burning its cities to ash in 3 short years, we realized that we had severely underestimated them. Not much later, our own people faced this new scourge. Our Kipchak brethren to the east fought bravely, but were easily defeated, and several of their Khans were captured. The Mongols buried the Kipchak Khans alive underneath a podium on which the Mongol commander, Subutai Bahadur, sat to celebrate his victory. The Mongols called it an honorable death, only reserved for nobility and royalty. I believe that these Mongols are evil demons sent to torture us. Only the western part of our once mighty confederation remains, and with it, the great Cumania has become a mere shadow of its former self. However, one of the Khans, Kotyan, recognizes our peril and is rallying all of the tribes to unite against the invaders. Mighty Khan, I was unable to convince the Cuman chiefs and Rus princes to fight against the Mongols. You will have to meet them in person. The Dnieper River will run red with the blood of Tatar and Mongol horsemen. Thank you. So many tribes already fell to the invaders. May the Sky God be on our side in the upcoming battle.
The Mongols took one of our princes hostage. Save him, and we will join your war.
Cuman horsemen, you are the last saviors that I would have expected. My father is an important man. Free me, and my people will be in your debt.
You have saved our prince, and we owe you a great deal. We will put in a good word for you with our ally, Kiev.
You have the blessing of the prince. Fair enough. Bring your warriors to me, and I will heal them.
Mongol scouts started attacking our people, and they have blocked an important supply route to the north. Destroy the blockade, and we will talk. Keep our promise, and our soldiers will fight alongside Cumans. At least for now.
have raised as many men for our army as we can. Now, we must destroy the encampment from which the Mongol vanguard operates.
You petty nomads know nothing about sieges. Thankfully, our engineers have constructed rams to batter down.
How I would like to twist the necks of these arrogant Rus!
Evet, anladım. Kuluk eder Barut anladım. Buyruk Anas. Kuluk etarm. Evet. Buyruk Anas. Marat Bey'in. Kuluk etarm. Evet. Anladım. Barurnien. Anladım. Kuluk etarm. Marat Bey'in. Evet. Barurnien. Buyruk Anas. Evet. Anladım. Kuluk etarm. Sançiska. Buyruk Anas. Solaşur biz. Evet. Sahiplenir. Buyruk Anas. Sançiska. Kuluk etarm. Solaşırız. Evet. Sahiplenir. Kuluk etarm. Sançiska. Solaşırız. Sahiplenir.
Excellent! We have burned the Mongol encampment to the ground. When their army comes, we will be ready. The Rus principalities were not easy to persuade. However, when news reached the Rus princes that a large Mongol army was riding west toward the Dnieper River, they accepted Kotyan's offer. Now, a united army of Rus soldiers and Cuman horsemen stand together to face the incoming Mongol horde.